Hi, welcome to the GMT today. Today we'll be looking at, want to study biology, and we'll be looking at the sense organ, the skin. Recall that an organ is made up of two or more different tissues working together to perform a particular function. And you know, we have different organs in the body. Like your lung is an organ, your heart is an organ, and like. But today we are looking at sense organs. Sense organs. There are basically five sense organs in mammals. We have the skin, which is an organ of touch. We have the tongue, which is an organ of taste. We have the eye, an organ of sight. The nose, an organ of smell, and the ear, an organ of hearing. But we will be concentrating today on the skin. The skin is an organ that covers the entire exoskeleton, endoskeleton of vertebrates. The skin is the largest organ in the body. Take note, it is the largest organ in the body because it runs entirely round the mama. Now, recall that animals are classified into two broad groups, the vertebrates and the invertebrates. The invertebrates are animals without backbone. Such animals, you will tell, they don't have endoskeleton. And maybe most of them don't even have skeleton at all. And the invertebrates are the sponges, the mollusk. The sponges, the example of the sponges is the collips. The mollusk, the snail. We have the annelida, the round one. We have the nematoda. We have the echinodermata. We have the platyhelminth, the flat one like the hookworm and the tapeworm. And we have the arthropods. We'll come to this later. Vertebrates are animals with backbone, while invertebrates are animals without backbone. And the vertebrates include the pieces where the fish and all the types of fish fall into. Please note, whale is not classified as species. It is classified under mammals. I will come to that later. The same reasons for classifying whale under mammal. So we have the pieces, we have the amphibians, which include the frog and the toad. We have the reptile, which include the tortoise, the snake, and lizards. We have the apes, which includes all types of birds, and the mammals, the cats, the dogs, the humans. Take note, we have mammals. They could be two-footed mammals like the humans or ungulates. Ungulates are animals that have hooves like your horse, and like they have forelimbs and hind limbs. Now back to the skin. The skin has three layers, but for your level as high school students and secondary school students, the layers of the skin are broadly classified into two, but when you go deep, you will see that the layers of the skin are classified into three. The outer layer called the epidermis, the inner layer called the dermis, and the fatty layer called the subcutaneous layer. Again, the layers of the skin are classified into three. It shows that the skin is thick and has layers like this. Looks like this. We have this. From this place to this place is the outer layer, and here is the inner layer, and anything here is the subcutaneous layer. The subcutaneous layer is basically made up of fat, where food is stored, and it also helps to generate heat during cold. And I will say something here. This fatalia helps to provide heat when the body lacks heat. It is mostly present in fat people and in females. Fatalia. So we expect that when we have two persons, a fat person and a thin person, the thin person should feel cold more than the fat person in the same ambient temperature. The fat person should feel warm because the fat person keeps producing heat from the subcutaneous layer. Also, when we have a female and a male of the same size, we expect that the male should feel cold while the female should feel warmer in the same ambient temperature because females have more fatty acids than male. That's why we have the different parts of the female shooting out. That is as a result of the fatty acid. Now let's look at one of the layers, the epidermis, the outer layer. Let's talk about the epidermis. The epidermis is the outer layer of the skin. It is made up of three layers. The mammalian layer, which is the inner part, inner layer. The granular layer, which is the middle layer. And the conifer layer, which is what we see. The conifer layer, which is made up of mostly dead cells that have been replaced on a regular basis. Conifer layer, which is the outer layer. Okay, let's look at the mammalian layer. The mammalian layer, which is the innermost layer of the epidermis. The mammalian layer contains actively dividing cuboidal cells. The cells are cuboid in shape and they are actively dividing. They are differentiating to increase in number. It also contains an infoldings that form the air follicle found in them. So when you look at this picture or this diagram, for example, you see that this thing is called air follicle. And we see the air follicle right on the epidermis, whereas it's coming from the dermis. So the mammalian layer contains infoldings that form the air follicle found in the dermis. It also contains melanin. Melanin is that pigment that helps the body form its color. Melanin is that pigment that helps the skin form its color. Albinism. Albinism is a condition, we call it mutation, that has affected the gene that controls